Happy Valentine's Day.
Indeed. I have been given a gift.
The gift of eternal love.
Nope. The gift of calories and expensive chocolate.
You asked for it.
I did. I usually do. That's kind of my go-to gift for have problems buying gifts for me. It's like, what don't you own? Like, well, I own all the games, so you don't get me that. But there is this one place in the US that does really, really good chocolate, which is rare because US chocolate, as a rule, is terrible. And that's Hershey's fault for the most part. But you might have heard on the podcast frequent mention of Norman Love Confections, which is in Florida, I believe.
It is in Florida.
Yeah, based in Florida. So the missus.
It is run by two people who are husband and wife.
Yep, it does.
Mary Love and Norman Love.
There you go. It does really high end kind of chocolate. They cater to like posh hotels. Like they actually serve these chocolates as desserts sometimes. But they can also ship them to you in sort of frozen freezer boxes and things like that.
This is not sponsored, by the way.
No.
I just want to mention that.
They can't afford to. I would love to take their money. I really would. But
they're like a boutique.
They're a little boutique, yeah.
I mean, I don't know how small they actually are. I don't know if they have multiple locations in Florida, but I would just call this very specialty chocolate. Like
it's
very
not cheap. Like no. It's not. This is not everyday stuff. This is occasion stuff. This is stuff that you're supposed to make last.
Yeah.
It usually doesn't with me, but hey. So I actually have a selection of things to show you.
Because I got them from him.
Yeah, I'll be tasting a couple of them. I'm not going to pig out.
I tried to get him some things that he had never tried before, so that way I could make content.
Indeed, these look pretty good. So these are candied orange, which is always nice. I'm a huge fan of citrus, people that don't already know that. Citrus is my absolute favorite thing in the universe.
I thought I was your absolutely favorite thing in the universe.
Nope.
But
I mean,
happy Valentine's.
Yes.
Day.
So this is it's probably. I'm not sure if it's peel, because I do like candied peel as well. Let's see. It just says orange, so it's chocolate and orange. That's awesome. As to be expected. That's nice. Those are like tiny little treats to have.
You're welcome.
Mm-hmm. Well, what do you want me to do? Thank you for all of the gifts multiple times. I can do that.
No, but I'm not your favorite thing.
You're not citrus, I'm sorry.
I'm not citrusy enough.
No, you're not citrusy enough for me, I'm sorry. What we do have...
Are you saying I'm not tart enough?
Well, I mean, you are a tart, but...
I'm not a tart, oh my god.
So these, I haven't seen these before. You were telling me a little bit about these.
Yeah, so these are chocolate seashells that they typically do in their boutique in Florida.
Yeah, the chocolate salon, they call it.
Yeah, the chocolate salon, which I wish we could actually have went there when we were getting ready to go on our cruise.
But we were hours away.
We found out it was like 2 hours away from where we were in Fort Lauderdale at the time.
Yeah, so if you've never seen... These are a little dusty because they don't do transit very well because they're not well protected, these
ones.
They
just got shipped today.
Yeah.
Or yesterday and arrived today.
So you'll see the kind of detail they put on them. They do a lot with color on the outsides, and usually their fillings are kind of fruit creams and things like that. You'll see a lot more of that in the boxes, but I don't know what's in this. I guess I'm going to try to find out. I saw the chocolate. I got away through.
But is it good?
It's dark. Yeah, not too dark. I do like dark chocolate. I'm not one of those guys that commands at 85%, so I'm not man mode enough for that. Oh yeah. A nice, rich kind of dark flavor to it. It's a shame that they kind of ship them in the... This is not an appropriate container for them.
I think it would be for the actual salon itself,
yeah.
Because they would not get shook around.
Can you even order these online? Like the...
You can now.
Mm-hmm.
I don't recall ever seeing them before until I ordered them.
It's a relatively new edition.
Yeah.
But yeah. I would recommend a different box, because this container, you'll see, like, it's all scuffed up.
Unless you're picking them up in person, in which case I think they would be
just
fine.
You know, it's a bit of a shame, because they really, they put a lot of work.
They're so pretty.
They put a lot of work in the presentation, and these boxes are designed around that, and this is just a little, like, thin, faint plastic thing, which is not...
But they look so pretty. Like, you can imagine them being in the shop and being
oh,
yeah, that looks
absolutely
really unique. I want to get that.
100%. So, you got me... There's only 6 pieces in this, but this is huge. So I don't know how many of this. This is s'mores caramel, apparently, as you can see. S'mores, for those who don't know, in the UK, it's a weird American thing they do. They love mixing caramel chocolate and marshmallow together.
And graham cracker.
And graham cracker, yes. Or graham cracker, as we like to say in the UK. We don't actually, we don't have that in the UK, unless
they... No, you just have Graham Norton.
Yeah, he's not quite as sweet. he's a bit bitter, actually, if you come to think of it. But these are, oh my god, these are huge.
Keep in mind that s'mores are actually pretty big here, because they're campfire.
Yeah, they're huge. These are massive.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't even want to bite into one of these because of just how big they are. Like,
they look really pretty, though.
Yeah, they do. Again, they put a lot of detail into this stuff.
Go ahead.
Which is why it costs an absolute fortune.
Okay,
I'll take one bite of it and then put it back. Jesus, look at the size of this thing. Yeah.
So typically it's graham cracker on either side, marshmallow in the middle, and chocolate.
That's exactly what it is. It's graham cracker on the bottom, marshmallow on the top, chocolate in the middle, which is delicious.
So the size could be intimidating, but the majority of it is going to be
That's a dessert. Like, that's not something you snack on. That's a damn dessert. I'm going to pop it back in there, and I'll kind of work on that over the course of the next
year.
Yeah. But yeah, they're very... Actually, surprisingly not as sweet. Like, the marshmallow isn't overpowering, and they use a darker chocolate in it, which works really well. So, I'm a fan of that. Yeah, it's pretty good.
I was hoping you'd like it.
Mm-hmm. This, slightly smaller, vanilla sea salt caramels. 15 pieces. And this is Dumb Cat, who's going to be in pieces if it continues to
fuck
around.
What is it with you and animal cruelty during my videos?
Because the cat always comes in and screws up. I mean, it's already broken two of the lamps in our lighting kit. Like, just by knocking it over, it demolished two of the boxes of stuff and scattered them all over the floor, so... The cat's a dick. It's as simple as that. Let's see if these are... What these look like. There you go. They actually look a lot like, there's one other chocolate company that I would actually recommend, which is L.A. Burdick's.
Burdick's have really nice chocolate-covered penguins.
And chocolate-covered mice and things
and
like
mice.
That.
The mice are so cute.
Yeah, they, and they do the things which are very much this kind of form factor, these very, very small
caramels. Now, see, you have a thing for sea salt caramel, which I actually don't enjoy. I don't know why I don't really like the salt with the sweet in that, because typically I would love that, but this is the one exception where I do not like salt.
Those are
sweet.
Probably the best sea salt caramel I've ever had. Like,
yay, I chose wisely.
Yeah, perfect balance. Really easy to screw that up. You either go too sweet or too salty. You gotta get the balance right.
And especially with you, I mean, we already know how salty you are.
Only when Jesse's around, screwing up my Overwatch comp. I got a fancy bastard, look at me! The cartoon act isn't cute, you're losing us the game. Alright. So, I've always been intrigued by these, but I've never had them. And that is like the coolest box ever. These are simply called black. They are their dark chocolate selection. I've never had these before. I have always been curious.
They looked really cool on the website, and so that's why I got them.
Yeah.
I wanted you to try things that you hadn't tried before.
They're probably some of the most impressive looking things that
they do. The ones that will all be busted up.
I hope not. No, their packaging is usually really good.
Oh, I know.
They are... Presentation-wise, I think they were the best-looking ones on the site.
They are, or were, anyway, we'll see.
And I think this might be true as well. Jesus, look at that!
Can you turn them around so we can actually see them properly?
Yeah, there you go. That...
I actually want to turn them so that way the viewers can see them the way they're meant to be viewed, if
okay.
That makes sense. No, I'm sorry, but they're really pretty and I just don't want to
tip them everywhere. There you go.
Fine. They're so pretty. That pearl, like, coating is just so gorgeous.
Well, I like the fact that they've, because the other ones, they do a lot of different shapes, which is really cool,
but this is
very uniform.
Yeah,
it's like
minimalist.
It's a set,
sort of.
You know,
yes.
They're meant to be presented as a set, and if you notice, there are five types based on their cocoa mass.
Yeah, different places where the cocoa is sourced.
Yeah, it's all single origin dark chocolate, which, you know, is always good. As I say, I'm not much of a connoisseur of dark chocolate.
Yeah, but if you ever wanted to find out if you liked certain chocolate from a
certain
region,
well, I mean, there's an 88% from Venezuela in there. That's probably... I should probably try that one just because I'll probably hate it and people will enjoy...
Which one is the one from
the red
Venezuela?
One.
Ooh.
The red one is the most intense.
So this is 88% cocoa mass, which is...
Are we going to get the mass bitter face from you?
Probably. This is probably far too much for me, but I'll try. You know, I surprisingly can deal with that. That's really, really nice. And that's weird, because 88% should be super bitter, but it's not. It's very, very dark.
Mm.
But it is absolutely delicious. Mm. Mm. Wow. Well, there you go.
That's the darkest one they have in there, right?
Yeah.
So everything else you should be able to cope with.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's
good.
Usually I can't deal with like 85% or higher. That's 88%, and that's really good.
You have one more present.
I do.
Because that wasn't enough chocolate.
Well, this will hopefully last me a few weeks.
Hopefully more than a few weeks.
Like, because these are the ones where you have like one a day, you know.
Mm.
Oh, well, I haven't got the red on my finger. This is just the standard box.
No,
apparently it's not. Okay.
This is the special Valentine's box.
Oh, I was not aware they did a special Valentine's box.
They did.
Okay. There's a little note in it. Yeah. They always like have these within 21 days, blah, blah, blah. Because, yeah, they're fresh, you know. They literally make them on that day and then ship them to you. Which is also why they're ludicrously expensive and you shouldn't buy them regularly. Alright. So, what is in the Valentine's Day selection? Well, I guess we can find out because they tell you right here. Lots of hearts, it would seem.
This is the 2016 First Love Collection. So there's a five spice, a lime, a French silk, a I don't want to butcher that, and a crema
I liked how you didn't want to butcher that, but then you butchered the next one.
No, I couldn't read it because your finger was in the way.
Guanduja or something along those lines.
Yeah.
And then on the other side.
Muscadine, macadamia, eclair, java fudge, and pineapple.
Mm. I want to go for the lime one, I think. If I'm going to try any of them, the lime one. As I said, I love my citrus. That's what they look like.
I'm gonna steal this for a minute because I want to be able to show them properly. Like.
Yeah.
How pretty. Like, I mean...
Each one is a work of art.
Like,
you know?
This one here, I just love this. I don't know why. It's just so... Yeah. It's haphazard, but it's
that
like
one doesn't tend to last long whenever I get it, because that shell's really nice, as is the green and yellow shell.
Oh, this one here?
Yeah, that's
I can't point.
The green...
Look,
yeah, that's
one.
A kind of lemon-lime one. The yellow one with the white splash in the middle, I believe, is kind of a lemon truffle of some sort.
It's just... They're so... pretty. I can't even tell you.
That's the problem with buying them. Most people don't want to eat them because they look
so pretty. I remember the very first time I ever got these chocolates sent to me, and it was not actually by my husband. Our graphic designer, Chris, actually sent them to me for my birthday.
Fair enough. Buttering up the boss is okay. If it was anybody else, I would be suspicious.
No, he's the one who discovered Norman Love.
He did, yeah.
And sent them to me. And I really did not want to eat them because they looked so beautiful.
Yes.
I couldn't.
I, on the other hand, don't give a shit about that.
You do.
Yeah, I'm going to have one, and that's going to be it for me for the day, which is going to be the lime one because I love lime.
And you're curious.
It's very, very rare to get good chocolate with lime in it in this country. They just don't do the combination that well.
I mean, you would think in Florida because of key lime and key lime pie and such that perhaps,
Yeah?
Is the inside just chocolate? Or is it like a creme? Ah, just
It's
chocolate.
A chocolate cream with fresh lime.
Ooh, very cool.
I mean, literally what they do is really quite simple. I mean, usually it's some kind of chocolate cream and then they just mix it with fresh fruit juice right there. And that seems to be the way that they do things, but it tastes fantastic.
I guess when you don't have to put so many preservatives in your chocolate because it is boutique style.
Yeah, there's basically almost no preservatives in this at all. And that's why they go off in like
This does
weeks.
Sound like a complete shill for the company, but we've really enjoyed Norman Love as a gift to each other. We get it every year for Christmas, every year for Valentine's Day, birthdays and whatnot. It is like one of our go-to gifts just because we really do enjoy these chocolates way too much than is healthy.
Well, thankfully, they're so expensive we can't enjoy them that often.
This is also true.
Yeah. These are, you know, a couple of times a year kind of experience. But if you want to check them out, the website is in the description below. As I said, we're not being sponsored by them because they couldn't afford us, but they are amazing. And if you're looking for a
a good gift, a really good gift in the US in particular for somebody special, then these are a good choice.
Yeah, and can I just say that Mary Love actually called me the other day on the phone, because when I got back from the cruise, I step off the cruise ship and I'm like, oh crud, Valentine's Day is coming. And I went to the website.
Yes.
Well, no, not like that, but I really
wanted to... I ordered her a gift a month ago, by the way. Just want to point that out.
Thanks. But...
Just say.
So, Norm and Love only do a...
Who's organized? I'm organized.
A limited run of Valentine's stuff before, you know, because they need to ship it in time for it all to get here before Valentine's Day. Coincidentally, today is not actually Valentine's Day. It is the, what, 11th?
Yeah, we're cheating, but we're releasing this on Valentine's Day anyway. Time delayed content.
Indeed.
So, mostly because leaving these for a few days is
would
not
never
good.
Work.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Anyway, I placed an expedited order as best I could, and I found out it wouldn't arrive until next Wednesday. But because I don't know if Mary and Norman even know who we are.
Probably
they
not.
Probably don't. If they did,
like,
they probably
we're the assholes who keep crashing
the
website.
Yeah. But she called me and let me know that she was expediting my order and it would be here the very next day. And that is just like a level of customer service that is unheard of in these times, in my opinion. I don't know. I would not expect that of a smaller company that, you know, doesn't...
Yes. This is really, really boring. Let's wrap up the video.
I hate you.
So, I'm going to talk about 5 minutes about shipping information. No, you're not on my level yet. You can't do that. 10 minutes of options menus? No. You need some experience. Do some more videos. Not involving me. Don't look at me like that.